Thanks for staying with us. Now, Bill, let's talk about AEC. This is the big jargon that has been said for the past few years. Is the hospitality industry or tourism, for that fact, ready for an integrated economy?
It's a work in progress. And you know, we've seen the effectiveness of the European Union, certainly. Mm-hmm. But Asia's different as well. We understand that the guidelines of the AEC and how it's going to operate is not going to be to the depth of the EU. But also, it offers a lot of challenges, but also a lot of rewards. Mm. I think Indonesia has a great perspective position to have leadership in this, and I think that's key
to
for the country.
To take leadership in this?
Absolutely. You know, you're Southeast Asia's biggest economy, again, so you have a lot of resources as well. Mm. And rather than trying to protect certain industries, it's a matter of opening things up. And I think for Indonesians, it gives you more international exposure, but also gives Asia the face it needs. You know, Indonesia's within 6 to 8 hours of half the world's population.
Right.
You know, Asia is where things are for the next few decades. So this is where the playing field is for the for broad economic growth across the globe. So I think it's an exciting time also, but you have to focus on what the opportunities are rather than just saying we don't want to give up anything from our side of the field, but also what are we going to take from the other markets.
Right.
You know, by having new you know, perhaps some foreign integration from ASEAN, from countries as well, I think that's going to benefit because the skill set will change, it'll change productivity, it'll also push up measures. I think you can import knowledge from countries like Singapore and from other ASEAN neighbors as well.
Well, talk about economic integration. I mean, ASEAN has been integrated since it was established. So it's just extending that integration into other parts of Asia.
I mean, the biggest ASEAN diplomatic mission per se have been the low-cost carriers, AirAsia, terms of how they're linking up the economy. So this is a natural progression, but now it's something official in terms of you have opportunities for Indonesians to invest abroad, you have foreign ownership from hotels coming into Indonesia as well, and also trading in terms of employment as well, which I think is a good thing because it gives you a more international workforce.
And should this also call for a change of for a harmonization of policies, tourism policies in between ASEAN and other Asian countries?
It's like with any family, you always have accord and you'll have discord, and I think that's a growing thing. Mm-hmm. But I think what it does offer for Indonesians is for the next generation of entrepreneurs, the expansion beyond the borders of Indonesia. Mm-hmm. That's exciting for us. Mm-hmm. You know, hospitality brands. I look at Ronald Akili at Potato Head. You know, he's moved from Bali to Jakarta, now to Singapore as well. We look at some of the other domestic hotel brands, Art Hotel, certainly in terms of their expansion policies. I think what excites us about it is the opportunity for entrepreneurs, not just within Indonesia, but to expand outside the borders.
Now, but would you say that because some business communities in Indonesia, even the Chamber of Commerce is admitting that the idea of economic integration has not trickled down because the discussion remains on policymakers' level, but not the business practitioners, not the doers on the grassroots level.
It's going to be contentious, certainly contentious, you know, in terms of foreign ownership of hotels, or that's going to be contentious with existing Indonesian hotel owners. Land ownership continues to be contentious. Employment continues to be. So again, like any family, you're going to have a dysfunctional family, you know, in terms of certain times. It is a rocky road, but at least there's a platform to discuss and move forward, and there is an initiative, and there are rules which are guiding and initiatives. I think, you know, there has to be a starting point. So if we're at day zero with the AEC, that's fine. At least we're at a starting point.
Right. Okay. Now, you speak about Indonesia taking a leading role in the economic integration. Mainly, we talk about the hospitality and tourism industry. How can Indonesia do that? How can Indonesia take that lead?
I think, you know, tourism's important. Tourism is the brand of the country. You know, much like Bali is. You know, Bali is a global brand, but Indonesian hospitality, Indonesian cuisine, Indonesian fashion, Indonesian art, these ideas in terms of that, it's a great face for the country. So in terms of its relevance to a more global economic picture, you know, having tourism here, and you know, people do like coming here. They do like the ability to have something unique, a specific culture, and there's a lot of diversity in the country. The one thing about Indonesia, it's not just one cultural aspect. It's a blending of the east, of the west, of the south, of the north. There's so many different ideas there. So I think it's very attractive because there's a lot of depth to it. There's no other country quite like Indonesia.
So you can bring about the type of promotion or exposure that you've done to Bali and other small islands, Lombok, Kili, to other parts of Indonesia.
And I think part of that is you can't just rely on the government. You know, the private sector traditionally, the hotel brands, the tourism players are the ones to promote the brand and define it. So you can't just rely on the government to do your work. The heavy lifting will be done by the hotel brands, by the tourism players, and how that messaging is going across from tourists.
So you'd say that at the moment that the private sector is relying on the government, or is it not vice versa?
The government relies on the private sector.
At the moment, the government is relying on private
Absolutely,
sector.
Because at the end of the day, transport comes, airlift comes from the private sector.
Right.
There's some infrastructure improvements, but also hotels are the ones promoting abroad. No matter how much money the government spends in promoting specific campaigns, it's the hotel brands which are promoting their products abroad, going to trade shows, reaching out to the tourists. They're the ones interacting. They're the ones engaging with tourism, right? So those are the people. That's through engagement, you're reaching a much broader market, you know, for hotels.
And we'll be right back after this short break.